Hey, fellow scientists, I'm Justin, and welcome to Earth. In this course, we'll be investigating the Earth and its place in the universe. So, obviously, I knew this was the only place we could do today's lesson. What's that, Mia? Almost every Earth scientist is way down there on the ground? Well, how do they learn about the Earth from way down there? Guess I better head back down to find out. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to explain how scientists make observations and ask questions to learn about the world around them. Let's get into it. Woo! Head rush. Anyway, how do scientists learn about the Earth? Well, they use a little something called the scientific method. I know it sounds kind of complicated, but really the scientific method is just a set of steps that all scientists follow. These steps help them ask questions and discover answers in a scientific way. The scientific method begins with something we do every day, making observations. But what is an observation? An observation is information we collect about the world using our senses. When we see a fluffy cloud, smell warm cookies, hear soft music, taste tangy juice, or touch a scratchy sweater, we're making observations. For example, I could observe that Mia here is small and she smells kind of like a penny. Oh, no offense, Mia. What observations can you make? Try to use multiple senses to observe the area around you. Pause the video and record your observations in your guided notes. Now let's practice by making observations about this scene. What do you observe? Well, I observe that someone dropped an egg on the floor. Oh, you're right, Mia. Was that an observation? I didn't use my senses to see anyone dropping the egg or hear it landing on the floor. So actually, I did not observe someone dropping the egg. What can I actually observe? I can see a broken eggshell sitting on what looks like a wooden plank. If I reached out and touched it, I would feel sticky, wet egg yolk. Those are all observations. We make observations about the world around us all the time. But when we pause and let those observations spark our curiosity, the scientific method can truly begin. The next step is to ask a question. But a scientist doesn't ask just any question, they ask a scientific question. A scientific question is one that can be tested by doing an experiment or gathering evidence. For example, after observing the broken egg on the floor, we might ask, what caused the egg to fall? Why does an egg break when it hits the floor? Would an egg break if it fell on the rug instead of the hard floor? Using our observations, we can ask a ton of different scientific questions. Why don't you give it a try? Take a moment and review the observations you made earlier about the area around you. What are some questions you could ask about them? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Scientists learn about the Earth by using these steps of the scientific method. This starts with making observations and asking questions. Everything we've learned about the Earth began with these steps. What's something you already know about the Earth? One thing I know is that the Earth is round. That's something that scientists have known about our planet for thousands of years. But how did they figure that out? It all started with observations. For example, sailors saw that as ships sailed away, they didn't just get smaller and smaller until you couldn't see them anymore. Instead, they disappeared from view over the horizon. The bottom of the ship disappeared first, and the top of the mast was the last thing you could see. People also observed something strange about the stars. Different stars could be seen in the night sky depending on where you were on Earth. Some stars could only be seen if you traveled far enough south, and others appeared only in the north. This got scientists asking questions. Why do ships disappear over the horizon like that? And why do we see different stars in different places? These questions led them to investigate and test their ideas. By thinking about these observations and asking the right questions, they discovered that the planet is round. This is how scientists work. They start with what they observe, ask questions, and then look for ways to find answers. Whether they're studying the Earth, the stars, or anything else, the scientific method helps them make discoveries and understand the world around us. Let's review everything we've learned today. Scientists use the scientific method to guide them through asking and answering questions. The scientific method begins with making observations and asking scientific questions. To learn more about observations and questions, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Oh, I agree, Mia. It's amazing that everything we know about the world around us came from simply being observant and staying curious. But how do scientists actually find the answers to their questions? That's what we'll uncover next time. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time.